Good morning, everyone. Today is the 22nd of October, Saturday morning, and I hope you all are having a good weekend so far. So, the older I get, the more I realize that these old bodies are wearing out. Regardless of what we do, we can try to eat all the right foods, we can try to exercise, we can try to do all the right things, but yet they're not sustainable. So much for sustainability. You know, I've said before, there's a song that these people sang. It's called "I'm All Wore Out." You know, if we're in Christ, we're going to get new bodies, and we're never going to have to worry about if we're going to be able to walk, if we're going to be able to talk, if we're going to be able to breathe, if we're going to be able to participate in life. We're never going to have to worry about that again. And I'm looking forward to getting a whole new body. I'm looking forward to that. And it's all because of the result of the fall that we're in this condition. But God made a provision to get us out of this mess. Not only through the eternal covenant between the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, but also the fact that He was manifested in time. You know, and He came into this world to save His people from their sins, but He also, not just to save them from their sins, but to give them new life for eternity and a glorified body. So we have a great hope. We have nothing to boast in and of ourselves. There's nothing that we can say that we did to earn this great gift that God has given us. Some people spend their whole life thinking they are earning this gift, and they go about seeking to do all of these things that they think are going to merit God's favor. That's what the Pharisees did. The Apostle Paul was brought up under Gamaliel, and he said he was a Pharisee of the Pharisees. And he said that he counts it all as dung. All of his education is done. Now I have a question for you. Do all these theologians that have these doctor in divinity degrees, masters in divinity degrees, do they count it all as done? I don't think so. I think they prize it. They show it off, don't they? You know, I do not take pride in the fact that I've got a degree. In fact, I've renounced it publicly. It's dung. Most of it was lies that I was taught. You know? And God's the only one that can give us spiritual understanding. You know, there are many things I don't understand, but this one thing I do know. I know Christ, who has the world in the palm of his hand. I may not know much about physics or chemistry. I may not know much about electronics or electricity. But I know the one who stills the wind and calms the sea. I may not know Hebrew or Greek or quadratic equations, but I do know the one who gave me eternal salvation. I may not know important people or celebrities, but I do know the one who created them all, as well as you and me. I may not know economics or how to get wealth, but I do know the one who grants spiritual health. I may not know false science and heliocentricity, but I do know the one who shed his blood on Calvary for me. I may not know Latin, French, or Portuguese, but I do know the one who made the stars and the trees. I may not know medicine, herbs, and plants, but I do know the one to me who forgiveness grants. So if you think you're wise in all worldly things, only Christ can bring knowledge the world cannot bring. May the good Lord be with you today in a special way is my prayer. God bless.